Robert has a little issue back here where he can't turn his neck this way. So we're going to just work on his neck.
No reasonable explanation for it either. Simply is.
So welcome Robert to the show. So this is the Beamer. This is bioelectric magnetic energy regulation. So the thing is that if we have good circulation and blood flow, we are healthy, right? Everybody should have one of these in their home. It's actually kept me in Florida, kept me employed. So, we have different settings here on the Beamer that we're gonna work with tonight. We are gonna set him at a very higher level than I normally would, just because he's in major pain.
I have a real pain in the neck.
Yeah. So, yeah, he has a real pain in the neck. So we're going to work on his neck pain, okay? And what the Beamer does is it actually goes to the area that is inflamed and brings down that inflammation amazingly, okay? So we're gonna turn him on.
I'd like to be turned on. And I need to be all fresh because we're gonna go singing after this. I'm gonna get some singing done. I think we found a place that doesn't require me to wear a mask, so I can go there.
So he's a happy camper. All right, so we're gonna work on Robert's neck, okay? Now this is the magic. The story, if you guys got on last night and you saw my story, on Sunday, I did a video, and the Beamer, I used this to wrap around my chest because I actually found lumps. What is happening? I'm back. Sorry, guys. We just got shut off. I don't know why. In the name of Jesus, that isn't going to happen again. Okay. So this is actually what I used to wrap around here when they found that lump. It keeps going in and out.
You wrapped it around your boots?
I wrapped it around this area right here.
Oh, below the boots.
Yeah, because I had a lump right here.
Oh, on the bottom?
And I don't know what happened, but within 2 months, the lump was gone. Okay, I don't know. I didn't go get it diagnosed. I didn't go to the store.
For the whole 2 months, you didn't go to the store. Nothing. No. You had.
Well, sometimes I'll just go like to Walgreens.
You felt like you didn't use it for a lump that was undiagnosed, and the lump disappeared. This is what you're saying.
I don't know why it keeps shutting down, but it's shutting down.
What do you mean by shutting down?
It's going dark and light. Okay, so
it's because of the clouds.
Okay.
It's not the. Oh, wait, hold on. My water.
So basically, we're gonna work on his neck, on this area here, to bring his circulation and blood flow back. Once he has that circulation and blood flow, this whole area can begin to start to heal. Okay. Now I'm not saying the Beamer heals, the treats, cures anything, but it brings your circulation and blood flow back. So over time, as you have your good circulation and blood flow, your body will begin the healing process. That's what I'm saying, okay?
Am I supposed to like hold it like that?
So we're basically just gonna work on his neck.
And this, am I supposed to point this at anything?
We're having a little issue here, guys. Hold on just a minute.
R2, we need more power.
Technical issue. Yeah. Okay. So this is the Beamer. Okay. This is what actually took the fishbone out of my foot. Probably about, let's see, in February, so it's been way over a year.
It took a fishbone out of your foot?
Yes. So this here.
What are you doing? Hold on. How did you get the fish bones you put in
the walking on the ocean. But you guys see this? This is the round thing that I put on the bottom of my foot. And it actually pulled because, remember, it was giving me good circulation and blood flow, right? So it actually pulled like a magnet. The fish bone came down lower and lower and lower. The more of these that I did, it actually pulled the fish bone out of my foot. Yes, saved me for $10,000 surgery.
$10,000 to get a fish bone out of your foot?
That's how much it would have been.
Oh my gosh! Call me. I have tweezers.
No.
Give you half price.
Robert, they cut. That's funny. They cut it an inch and a half deep. And they still couldn't get it out.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So guys, what we're doing.
Looking forward to you having much better luck in your life.
What we're doing tonight is I'm gonna show you the light. I do facials all the time, women and men. And that's why I look so young to be the other day somebody said I look 32. I said no way, that keep going. And it felt really great, right?
I'm 97.
And So, all right. So I'm gonna show you how this works.
Now, is this like doing something now?
Yes. And I'm gonna show you. You guys hear that?
Yeah. What does that mean?
That means that there are electrical little pulses that are helping us get our circulation and blood flow back. But Robert, did you feel anything?
Yeah, I feel like a little bit of warmth maybe in the back. I don't know.
But I just mean, do you feel any tingling or anything? It's not a TENS unit, so you don't want
to... I don't feel any blood getting to my brain yet.
Now, when he's all done, we're hoping that he's going to be able to go all the way over to the side.
Yeah, because I didn't demonstrate beforehand, but I should have, but basically I can't really look to the right very well right now. For no reason, I just woke up that way yesterday and it kind of stuck with me. So.
Well, you know what I say, right?
Blame it on your twin flame, blame everything on your twin flame, yeah.
No, I say you're healed in Jesus' name.
Okay. Hey, red light.
So this is red light therapy, guys, okay? So we're gonna kind of give him a little bit of a facial. So, but you do keep the glasses on.
I was joking about the blue light.
You do keep the glasses on. I know.
Some people don't know me as well. What am I supposed to do with this?
Just hold it right there.
Stick it in my face?
Just hold it right there.
Is it like supposed to, is this like a facial thing?
So or? If for some reason, Robert, let's say his sinuses were all clogged up and he couldn't breathe, then I would have him put that right there. Okay, and I disinfect this each time I'm done.
Yeah.
So, just so you guys know, it's disinfected.
So should I point this to my neck or?
Well, we're using this first.
Oh, okay.
Because with this, I'm also helping you stay young.
Well, there we go.
Because Robert doesn't have anything going on with his face or anything, but with his neck, he can't turn his neck all the way. So we're gonna see. So if you just jumped on tonight, I'm talking about the Beamer. No, it's not a car. It's actually a circulation therapy machine that I bought. It was the best decision that I ever made. Now I can help people get their circulation and blood flow back. I got the fishbone out of my foot. And then after I got in that accident, you know, I had whipped all the way around in my car. So I had some lower issues here. And you know, nothing was taken care of at all. So the Beamer has helped my lower back tremendously. All right, so that one shut off.
The neck thing?
Hold on, just a minute. So we're gonna stop it.
Oh, I was just getting a good facial too.
Well, I'm gonna put you on the different mode. So basically, we're gonna switch him over.
To different.
So we only want to go, we normally only want to go with intensity one if it's the first time somebody's using it. But if they're in pain, we have to go just a little bit higher. But we only recommend intensity one for 8 minute session, and you do it twice a day in your home. You also can sleep on this. It has a sleep mode on it. So we're gonna start it back up again and help. He's being funny. Okay.
Hey, wait, so I don't have any red light therapy going on.
I know, I'll get it. Do you guys hear that?
That's me beaming.
You hear it?
I'm beaming.
Beam me up? That's why they call it beamer, right? So what this is going to do, this 8 minute session that we just did, we're going to see now if he can move his neck a little bit.
I've always been just, this is kind of quick right there.
Okay, so.
So now we're going to go into red light therapy.
Now what we're going to do is turn this off.
I don't go by that far. And for no reason, I just wake up and suddenly I can't move my head.
Okay.
Just habits, right?
Yes. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to.
I went singing on the beach.
Change this. I'm changing it to. This is what took the fishbone out of my, to the bottom of my foot, okay?
It's like a magnet?
Yes, it's like a magnet.
It's a button so magnet?
You can even put it on the bottom of your foot if you have issues with your feet. If you have a a head cramp, we call them, you know, you can put them on there, on your head. Of course, it's really great to take a dropper full of CBD if you have a headache too. It's awesome. So,
so we're going to apply that to the neck.
So now we're going to apply this to the back of his neck.
Which will pull the fishbone out.
There's no fishbone in his neck.
When I was sleeping somehow.
That's fine.
But this is some kind of magnetic therapy now, is that right?
Well, it's basically a little electrical pulses that you don't feel, but they're basically pulling the blood and the blood flow back through to the body. Your blood flow and your circulation. So now we've got him switched over. And
right, so where are we going? We're going to Mugs and Jugs to sing?
Yep, we're
going to
be
right, everybody plan on going to Mugs and Jugs to sing in Clearwater. Tell them where it's at so they can meet us there. We're going to sing, and you'll be able to see me, my neck actually work. we're hoping anyway. Mugs and Jugs in Clearwater. Because I can go in there without a mask. That's what I'm told.
All right, guys, so I just wanted to tell you a little bit about what we were doing here. If I knew what I was doing.
Luckily, okay. It only causes excruciating pain when she presses the wrong button. Yeah.
Okay. So, we got him switched over now. All right. So, we're going to have him hold it in the area where it is inflamed. He's got some inflammation in this area. That's what's causing his neck to not be able to turn.
Yeah.
And when you turn it, you're messing it up. I don't know.
Oh, am I turning it?
Yeah. You're shutting it off. So, hold on.
Oh, it has my neck.
It's still going. It's still going. It's okay.
All right,
so.
We're good.
We're basically going to do an 8 minute session, and while we do this session, we're going to talk about our spiritual journey, okay? That's what this show is about tonight. So I'm going to have Robert start talking about how we all got this started.
I just wanted to say that ideally we were thinking this would be a week kind of deal, and then we were led this after our last show to wait to do the next show, and then we waited and we did that show, and then it came out to where it was inaudible. So obviously we didn't wait long enough, and so now it's now time for you to get the next message. And what we were led, I asked God about it. I said, God, why are you messing with the show? I thought you wanted us to do this thing. And what he was saying was really important, I think, so I'm going to share it with you. And that was that he doesn't want you to rely on me or to rely on her or the show. Our job here is not for you to become reliant on us for the information. Ideally, you should already be developing that relationship and that dialogue with God. And so by us not having that next show, you were actually forced into some tower moments as you were trying to stand in your truth and learn how to talk your truth and be kind. And you may have been triggered and been mean to somebody and felt bad about that. Or a lot of things could have happened, but ultimately those things ideally pushed you towards your conversation with God and started to help you develop and your footing in the faith. That you know, and started to see some of the magic around you. And so ultimately, though, what we want to talk about in this show is how, now that you know your truth, or at least you're finding it, okay, you're getting into it, you're starting to recognize it at the very least, and you're starting to want to speak it, you're realizing you get kickback when you have that. But what we're going to do today is we're going to tell you how to handle that kickback in a loving, caring way so that it helps propel you forward, because anything in life can either propel you forward or it can push you back. And so it's always a decision. And so what we're going to decide now is all these people that may give you pushback are going to help propel you forward, and we're going to show you how to do that today.
So I started out with showing you guys the Beamer because this has helped me a lot. So for those of you that just signed in, hello to you. Welcome to the show. This is Living a Healthy Lifestyle. For those of you that I've just met, this is Carrie Davis. And but this is the miracle here has helped me so much with getting my circulation and blood flow. It's been huge, right? And this is actually what took the fishbone out of my foot. So we're hoping that when Robert's done doing the isolation therapy, which he is, we're doing an isolation right here in this area where he can't turn his neck. So that's how we wanted to start the show out tonight. It's about your spiritual journey. The very first show we talked about how I was in the cocoon. And I'm no longer in the cocoon. So in the second show, remember there was some things that I was going through. There was some really hard times I was going through, and I was really super sick. I don't know what it was. I'm not gonna talk about it. So, but I was super, super sick, and I just went through a really rough time that week. And then this next week, some amazing things started happening. Doors started opening and I started getting jobs. Like, I'm getting jobs, lots of jobs, right? And it's like I switched over that mindset that I told you guys about. It's about your mindset. Everything is about mindset, you know? And if your mindset is good, you're gonna be able to get through your day. But if you're waking up and you're like that stinking thinking first thing in the morning, right?
First thing in the morning is the most important part of your day.
To spend
Make
with
sure
God.
You control that part.
And spending it with God is really the way that everybody should start their day. I started with the Beamer. I set my alarm. If it's not a night to sleep on it, because I do sleep on the Beamer three times a week, okay? And it's completely, my back is, I'm riding bikes, I'm rollerblading. I mean, and I just got hit by a bus, guys.
Literally.
This is amazing, you know?
But can you just say, I actually got hit by a bus?
I did. I actually did get hit by a bus. So.
And had a bone in your foot.
And I had a fishbone in my foot, yeah.
I'm getting the fishbone out of my neck now.
So we're hoping that Robert's going to get a little more, being able to turn it, his neck a little bit more when he's done. And we've got him on a 20-minute session. So for right now, we're just going to hang tight here till I get situated. You don't ever want to put a $7,000 machine on a wet floor. So
let's get to the topic.
Yeah.
The topic at hand really today is you're starting to want to live your life now that you know who you are and you're wanting to break out of those ego barriers, and you're finding there's resistance. You're finding some people aren't really happy about the whole thing. Some people actually might be excited for you, but they're going to be probably the fewer than the many. And you're like, how do I navigate this without total destruction of my complete environment as I know it? Yeah, good luck with that. Because you're going to change, and your environment's going to change, because your environment is your energy. You project your energy, own your energy, you bring to the table, as someone was telling me recently. So basically, it's up to you. And what you're going to do is you're going to start to just try to always come from love and kindness. Because as you've learned, you now have all kinds of strength that you didn't have before. And you feel it, you know it, you walk around with it, people can see it with you. And basically, most of your strength is just in finally just learning how to actually speak your truth in a loving, caring way, wouldn't you say?
Yes, communicating with people in a more loving, caring level. Trying to really focus on where they're at in their lives. What they're going through, you know, you don't know that person in front of you that slammed on the brakes or almost got you in an accident. I mean, yeah, you know, it's scary, you know, because I got hit by that bus, but you don't know what kind of day they had, you know. I mean, somebody could have just died, right? We have all kinds of things that happen in our lives that we have to deal with on a day-to-day basis. It's basically how you deal with it. How do you deal with things that happen on a day-to-day basis? Well, my thing is, it's all turned around now. And I'm looking at things that Robert used to say, blessings. Blessings. And so tonight we're going to talk a little bit about me flying. But I wanted to go over a little bit about some of the shows we've done. And I want to apologize for the way that the shows aren't turning out. Guys, we're just starting this. And
it's all perfect.
I've been doing my show. Well, I call it my show, but it's God's show. I've been doing this show for about a year since I left the radio station. And now I'm trying to incorporate some series, you know, not just do a show, but have series of shows. So tonight we're going to talk a lot about the spirit-filled journey. I'm going through this journey now. You know, I've come out of the cocoon. I'm this butterfly and I'm trying to fly, right? And I've fallen on my face a little bit. We do. We fall on our face, right? Get back up and again, you know? So tell them a little bit about what tonight's show is going to be about. How you feel now?
I do not have as much resistance.
Awesome.
So I don't have as much resistance. That's good. It's an improvement. Do we have more?
Yeah.
Do I have more minutes? Yeah. Because the fishbone is still there. All right. So let me talk a little bit about what you're going to run into now on the most magnificent part of your journey. Because what you're going to start to notice, as you start to speak your truth, then you can start to live your truth. We've talked about that. And your art, the art that you're going to be developing right now, is speaking your truth with love and kindness. And you're going to get triggered. Forgive yourself right up front. You're going to get triggered. There's going to be people that are going to press a button, and you're going to go, ah, and you're going to just act inappropriately for whatever reason. And as part of the journey, forgive yourself, forgive the person that triggered you, and learn from it. And then, you know, remember, reflect, because there's a lot more there than just is readily apparent. Reflect and go, where in my life in the past does that relate? Because that one got me, you know what I mean? And then go back and think through those things and kind of heal them in a way by addressing them, forgiving the people that were involved in them, forgiving yourself.
Do you remember last week when we talked about forgiveness? And how important forgiveness is, you know, it's for us that it's important. It's for our health, right? The other person doesn't really care that we're mad or whatever. So I've been doing a little bit of that. I've been doing a little bit of that where I've been going back and telling people that I'm really sorry. Oh, you're moving around.
Yeah.
You're moving.
I'm beaming.
Don't be moving. He's beaming. So, if you just joined us, we're talking tonight about the Spirit Field journey, how we've gone through the series. This is supposed to be the fifth series, but guys, we're probably going to start the series over again because we've had some hiccups, you know, that happens in the movie business, but just kidding.
It's been perfect. I keep telling it's been perfect. It's been perfect. Trust me. Your journey is perfect. Don't judge it. And that's actually a lesson in this journey is don't try to make everything perfect. It's not going to be perfect. Actually, the most beautiful things in life are not perfect. If they were perfect, they wouldn't be all that special, would they? And so this journey, your journey with us on these shows and the way that they've come out has been perfect.
Yeah, so if any of you guys have done any homework on what we're talking about, any of you people, you know, that feel like you're stuck right now, and I talked about how stuck I felt, and I wasn't able to go anywhere. In my mind, you know, it was just, I was stuck, you know? And that was the time where I was stuck in the past, I think. I was really stuck in the past, and I couldn't let it go that my husband died or that my second marriage ended in divorce. I just couldn't let it go. And God was working with me to let that go. That's part of opening up into the butterfly and flying and letting that go. You know, even being friends with people that in your life, you know, that you've forgiven, that you feel comfortable with, you know. It's a tough journey. We don't have to hang out with the people that we're angry with. We shouldn't if they're toxic. But I've been through a lot of that in the last year or so. I've been through a lot of that.
Well, you're going to find that as a natural progression, as the tree grows older, it lets go of one season's leaves and it grows new leaves for the next season, and your life will be the same. So don't feel bad if some people fall away from your life as you grow and they come. They came into your life for a season and they brought what they brought, and be happy and glad in that, and then move on. You know, because the less you try to control your journey and the more you let it happen for you with your intentions, without resistance, and just start recognizing your emotions are valid, experience them, feel them, express them, look at the roots that you have in your life for them, then suddenly you're going to just start to have joy. And that joy will come from within. And as that joy starts to shine from within, then other people are going to notice. And that's when you're going to start to attract your new leads, your new people that are now the right people for you because you're yourself instead of what other people
so
want you to be.
You're not really who you really think you are until you go through your spiritual journey. I didn't. Like, I'm experiencing amazing things that are happening. You know, just like there's this really cool girl on there tonight. Her name is Ginger, and she's from Iowa. No, wait, Nebraska. Anyways, I get them all confused because we're hanging out right now while they're here in Florida. And she's on tonight, so I want to say hi, Ginger. Hi, Tony. I'm not sure else.
I guess we'll
see
you all soon.
But, you know, things that are happening, things, really good things that are happening, is what I'm focusing on. I'm so focusing on blessings. It's a blessing that I didn't get the stimulus check. Not yet, because I'm at that point where I'm learning to trust God to take care of me. And He's doing it. You know?
Did he not give you the stimulus check and have somebody else get the stimulus check?
Everybody's different. Just like when somebody else stole my roller skates this week. They really needed them really super bad.
There was some lessons for you in that, too.
There really was a lesson in that. I had to I had to stop crying about it. You know, it was a really great pair of roller skates that were gone. And somebody got into my back seat, and I don't have the proper key because I've had my car redone, you know, so I've got to go get the handle for the door for my car so I can lock it. So I just had my roller skates in there, and they're gone. But that lesson was basically trying to tell me that whoever got those roller skates, they needed them more than I did. And it's time to buy some new ones. So I'm gonna buy me a brand new pair of roller skates. And they're gonna have lights on them. So yeah, that was what happened this week. That was kind of a little bit of a downer, but it didn't ruin my day, you know? But what we're talking about is the spirit-filled journey. And tonight, like, I feel like I'm flying. I really do. Like, I know that I'm gonna crash again, and I know that I'm gonna experience what Robert's been talking about. He can explain a little bit about that with flying.
Yeah, it's a roller coaster. You're gonna have, everything is cyclical. You realize that there's gonna be good days and bad days. There's gonna be sunny days, there's gonna be rainy days, there's gonna be windy days, there's gonna be no wind days. And the reason for that is because without that, wouldn't life be boring? And so you got to take both. Both have their benefits. And so if you think, hey, when the wind is blowing, then you put the sails up and you take advantage of those, that wind, and you have it push you forward. And when the wind isn't blowing, then you get out the oars, or you take advantage of the wind not blowing, just relax on the open sea and watch that beautiful glistening of the water. I don't know. I'm just saying, in your situation, you always have the choice, don't you? To either find the way that it makes things bad or the way it makes things good, whether you're going to be afraid of it or you're going to be excited about it, you know what I mean? And that's always going to be your choice.
It gets kind of loud.
And so ultimately, though, what I'm trying to tell you is that you have it all within inside you. And now that you've found that to be true by going through our other shows and those steps, then what I want you to feel is that it's okay. It's okay to be you. It's okay to step out of your comfort zone and just do what you wanted to do.
And that's what I'm doing.
Instead of what everybody else was telling you to do.
That's what I'm doing. It's crazy. Like, I'm just doing what makes me happy right now. And before, it was all about everybody else and not me. That's kind of why I moved away from Iowa. Anybody here from Iowa? I can see some people on here from Iowa, my hometown of 22 years, and I do miss it. But the thing is that when we're in that desert, which is where I was, and we're stuck and we can't do anything about it, but we complain about it, then we remain. And now I'm not complaining about stuff. I'm actually talking about, it's a blessing, like I said, that I don't have a stimulus check, or I don't have any unemployment, right? It's a blessing. And that's what I'm looking at it as.
And so we can now take your journey and actually take that, and let's take you up a step. What you want to do is now, instead of noticing what may not be there, focus on what you're grateful for being there. Because, again, whatever you focus on will expand. So if I'm focused on how I don't have enough rain, God's going to give me a lot more drought. If I'm focused on how excited I am about that little kind of raindrop that hit me on the head in the middle of the drought, okay, then I'm really grateful for that, then God's going to give me more of those raindrops.
It's just like I got all these jobs last week, okay? Which I haven't even told you yet. I got all these jobs, and you know, God was actually coming in and just doing amazing things, you know? And I give him all the credit. I do, because I didn't do it within myself. I didn't go out and find any jobs. People were calling me. And I was like, wow, I didn't even advertise. What's the deal? So, all the things that I was stuck on in the past are the things that held me back. They are the things that kept me in the cocoon. And my friends would even say, well, you're still stuck on this and that and the other. And I was, guys, because you guys are also going through your spiritual journey. So you could be stuck somewhere in your spiritual journey right now. You could feel like you're this cocoon that can't do anything, that's just stuck where it is you're at. But you can really speed up the process when you start believing in yourself, first of all. You start loving on yourself, because it's so true that there's only one of you. So you have to love yourself before you can love anybody else. It's just so true.
Love is truth. They're synonyms.
Yeah.
And also love and God are synonyms. So God and truth are synonyms. All of those are synonyms. And so ultimately what you need to do is stand in your faith and in your truth. And you're going to find that it all just works perfectly. It does.
So,
and the more you believe in that, more you rest in that.
When you rest
more that's
in
gonna be true.
When you rest in faith, you rest in your faith, and you know that everything's just gonna work out. And you rest in that every day. You rest. I mean, it's just, I can't even begin to explain what rest is, but it. It's amazing.
I'll give a good example. I have a friend, I call him a friend, and hopefully there'll be more friends as time progresses, but this girl, she's monitoring her boyfriend as he's getting ready for the, what do they call it, the Iron Man competition, which is a tremendously hard competition, which I have ultimate respect for this guy for doing it. But ultimately, you know, one day he posted something that I just thought was just beautiful, and you should remember this on your journey, is that some days there's a time that you need to push through. Some days it's a time to rest.
Yes.
Know the difference. And the only way you're going to know the difference is by following your internal guidance.
Yeah, and I've been learning to do that. I've been following my internal guidance. I've been following God. Here's the thing, guys, and I've talked about this a couple times on a few shows. Fear and faith, they don't reside in the same area. They won't work. They clash together. The reason that we have faith is because God gives us that faith. He actually gave it to me because I started praying for it. So ask for it if you don't have
faith. He'll be happy
faith.
To give it to you. Just
He'd be happy to give it to you. But we have to ask. A lot of the times we don't get what we want, and I don't mean that we should get everything material that we want, but we don't receive because we don't ask. Our Heavenly Father loves us, but we need to ask Him, okay, this is what I need. I need these jobs, right? And so here comes these jobs. And they're just piling in, right? And I just told God, I said, I can't do this on my own. I need your help. And I mean, don't just go talk to God when you're hurting, okay? But other times too, like I'll get up in the morning and I'll just start talking to Him. You know, I have that relationship, and it's just pretty amazing. Or if you're sitting outside, and like right now, it's just so beautiful, and it did a little rain a little, but it stopped, and that's Florida for you, rain and stop, but it's just been amazing to sit out in God's nature, do something fun that you enjoy to do, to bring that good mindset to start that day off right. So so if you just joined us, we're talking a little bit about the spiritual journey, but I'm also telling you about the thing that took the fishbone out of my foot. This is bioelectric magnetic energy regulation. I put it on the bottom of my foot. I did 4 sessions, and that poison stingray came out of my foot that was in it for 8 months. So it's pretty amazing. But this is helping Robert. So Robert, is it better?
Actually, it's better.
Is it better than when you came? Yay! So in just a few sessions that he did, he's better. In just a few sessions, because he couldn't turn his neck when he got here, and that's why I pulled the machine out. And now you can turn your neck.
Not completely, but definitely it's better.
All right. So the more sessions that you do, the better it gets. So I'll talk a little bit about the femur later. I'm going to let Robert talk a little bit about flying, and then we're gonna end the show at 7:30 tonight, because we're all going out to do karaoke. So you might see us on again later, live. But
come out and see us.
For right now, Robert's going to talk a little bit about what it means to fly. And that's where I'm at right now. I'm flying. I'm actually out of the cocoon. I have, what did you call it? Awakened?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've awakened. Yeah. And now I'm flying, and I'm able to look at things as a blessing. You know, I look at things in my life as a blessing. So we're gonna end on this note with him talking about flying, meaning explaining everything, kind of go through a little bit and explain.
Yeah, let me explain what I mean by flying. What it means by flying is that now you know who you are, you're getting in touch with yourself, you're learning what actually makes you happy, you're deciding who you really are without everybody's input. And so then you want to live that, and you start to live that, you start to speak it, and that's when you're really starting to flutter, you know, fly your wings. And what I mean by flying, and why I think the reason why we end up calling it flying, is because when you start to actually live in your truth, the universe changes around you. And the only way you're ever going to get what I'm going to tell you right now is to step into live and speak your truth. Realize you'll never see this magic if you don't do those things. So I'm going to talk to you about actually flying. What I'm talking about is not flying with, you know, with your wings, okay? I'm talking about flying in your life. I'm talking about realizing the magic that has supported and surrounded you this entire time that you've been blind to. And you're going to start to see it. And when you start to see it, you're going to start to be lifted up. You're going to start to feel being lifted up by God and by the universe and supported on your journey, because you're on a true journey now. You're not living a lie. You're living the truth.
Amen.
And the truth is supported by love. The truth is supported by God. They are truth.
And that's where I'm at right now. I mean, I'm what he just explained is what I'm going through. So each week we're talking in this series about your spiritual journey. And I'm just looking at everything as blessings now, you know?
And they become more abundant for you.
The crazy thing, the only bad thing that happened this week was my roller skates got stolen out of my car. And that was made me really, really sad. But I was able to put my big girl panties on and go, all right, my skates are gone. I'm going to have to go buy me another pair of skates. And I can buy the ones with the lighted wheels now. So I'm looking more at things as a blessing. And that's just a small thing. There's so many people out there that I want to reach out to you for the last 5 minutes and tell you that Robert and I are praying for you. We know you're going through some wicked storms. You know, some of the storms that come through here are just major, where I only have 5 seconds to run over there, pull this down, run over on this side, and pull it down, right? I have to set my alarm sometimes if I know there's going to be a storm so that I can get it shut down, you know? I mean, it's crazy. But the thing is that the storms in our lives that we're going through, remember, Jesus walked across water, and the disciples couldn't believe it. And he will walk across water to help you. So with these storms that are going in your life, take a hold of his hand and pray. That's the best thing to do. And then instead of complaining about everything, because you will remain in the same spot that you're in as long as you complain, when you complain, the devil listens to that too. And he's like, huh, well, I'm going to make this worse. You know what I mean? So it's better just to, in our minds, just to think good thoughts, you know? Start off living a healthy lifestyle with your mindset. What are you thinking about? Is it stinking thinking? Because if it is, kick it out. If it's a bad thought, kick it out. Because you have that ability to do that. I've been doing that. Kicking out the bad thoughts.
As soon as we begin, we start to win, plucking the weeds from the garden with it.
So we're going to end on this note. We're not sure exactly where all this is going to go, but we're supposed to be done with the 5-week series, but you know, I got a little bit under the weather. Robert was a little bit under the weather.
I think that we probably have 2 more shows to go.
So we got about 2 more shows we're gonna do.
Main thing of homework is just practice noticing when you get triggered and looking at the roots, and then also forgiving everybody in the current situation and forgiving the people that you find with the roots. And then look for joy. Experience your emotions. You're going to be going through them. They're actually, right now, today, the 20th, we're going through another upgrade. So this is a significant day, actually, in humanity and our consciousness. So you're going to probably notice some aches and pains as you go through that. But realize it's all divine. It's all purpose. It's all supporting you. And it's all coming from love. And we're sending you love. And we're thinking about you, and we're going to see you on the next show. Until then, live your truth with love and kindness.
Yeah, do something for somebody, because I found that selfish people are very unhappy. So do something for somebody else, you know? Sometimes I just go out in the park and I just strum my guitar. I really don't even know how to play yet. And I might sing a song for somebody. Or I just do, you know, like the other day, I called somebody that was really sick. I mean, just do something for somebody, and that will get you the best day that you've ever had.
That's a beautiful ever. Day. Yeah, giving.
It's all part of it, guys. So thank you for watching Living a Healthy Lifestyle.
Thank you for joining us. Join us at, where are we going? To Mugs and Jugs. We're going to go sing.
We're
going to
go sing at Mugs and Jugs. So if you're in the area, we will be there. I want to say hi to everybody before we have to get off here. Hi, Aaron. How are you? Miss your music. Hi, Paul and Liz and Randy and Catherine and Garrett and Patrick and Angie and Belinda. Hi, Belinda. How are you, honey? Dolly. Hi, Dolly. And Leslie. And Sandy and Ginger's still on here, and Ken, Michael. I feel like I'm in Romper Room, really. And Tammy, if I have lost any of you. And Michelle, hi Michelle, how are you? I love your beautiful voice, honey. But thank you guys for getting on the show tonight. And Robert's neck is definitely a lot better. The Beamer is amazing. I'm gonna be doing free holistic health coaching. And I mean free. So if you want to give me a donation, that's fine. People do that, but I'm not asking for anything. I just want to help you get your circulation and blood flow back, get your life back on track again. And as I'm getting ready to graduate, I need 6 people. So, and I'm talking to everybody about CBD too. So stay tuned, because we're going to be giving some free stuff away in the next few days. And just be watching for that. So, love you guys. Take care. See you next week on Living a Healthy Lifestyle. And say goodbye, Robert.
Bye-bye, Robert.